Hey, Eric the Pondigger here. Today we're on a little excursion. We're in Upland, California. We're at the home of Mike Lacombe, our aquatic plant specialist. Now, Mike has a huge affinity for pond turtles, so I figured what better place to take you, since today our focus is going to be on the five most important things you need to consider when building a habitat for pond turtles. The pond that we're about to check out is really unique. It's about 4 foot deep, has a land bridge, multiple levels, so there's different areas for the turtles to hang out. There's multiple waterfalls, and the list goes on of the cool things we're about to show you. Let's go have a look. Hey, Mike. My God, your yard looks insane.
Good morning, Eric. How you doing?
Excellent. Thanks for having us out today.
Oh, no problem.
Obviously, you know why we're here today. We want to cover the five most important things that you should consider when building a habitat for turtles. And since you have this awesome habitat, I figured no better place to be. Can you tell us what you've done to your yard to keep it secure so the turtles don't take off?
First of all, the only gate that I have coming into my yard, I made sure that it was secure to about a quarter of an inch gap underneath it so baby turtles, big turtles couldn't crawl out. If they could find a way to dig out or crawl under something or even climb, they will. I never realized turtles could climb as well as they can until I built all this and had my turtles.
What have you done to your pond to protect them from predators?
Well, why don't we come over the bridge here and I'll show you what I've done. First of all, Eric, in every part of my pond, I've got what I call turtle tunnels, and they're places where the turtles can go down and hide. And also, the ledge doesn't gradually go in like this. It drops down really deep, so if raccoons come over the wall, possums, whatever, cats, they're deep enough where the predator cannot fish them out and eat them.
So I see these fish swimming up vertically like this. The pond's pretty deep. Tell us how deep it is.
Well, I made it 4 feet deep because having a small yard like I have, I wanted the most out of my pond so I could get the most turtles, most fish that I could have.
So 4 foot's deep. It's not critical to have a 4 foot depth, is it?
No, it's not, Eric. But the only thing that's mainly critical is the turtles have somewhere to go hide and to get away from predators if they need to.
Mike, tell us a little bit about the basking behaviors of your turtles, because a lot of people don't realize that the turtles need to climb out of the water and completely dry off each day. So I notice you have a lot of spots around your pond for basking.
Well, actually there is. They usually only want to hang out anywhere along the edge of the pond where they can slide into the water really fast in case, you know, a predator, hawk, raccoon, or whatever comes to get them. They feel more secure by being on the edge to be able to slip right in right away.
So they're more basking like on this stone and not out in this gravel?
Yeah, great. They go here, they go on the rock there, rock over there. Anywhere where this, you know, the sun hits right on the edge of the pond is where they'll sit out.
Well, see, the important thing is that they need to get out of the water and dry off certain times of day, like completely dry. And a lot of ponds, they don't allow them to climb out. So do they do that every day? I mean, are they all?
Well, yeah, that's very important, Eric, because if they're not able to sit out in the sun and get the warmth from the day, then it's harder for them to sleep under the water at night, which is what they do. And they can tend to get too cold and get sick and die.
So the topic of basking is important that I wanted to cover, which leads us to the next topic, is breeding. Because the female turtles, they want to lay eggs each season, and if they don't, you know, it's probably not good. So tell us what you've done to kind of stimulate the whole breeding thing.
Well, you're going to love this. I went to all the elaborate trouble to dig 3 foot of the mound out there and put all sand in there because my thinking was, well, that's how the sea turtles do it, so maybe that's how freshwater turtles do it. And they have laid eggs up there, but more than that, I find that they go in other places of the yard and dig their holes for the nests. And my ground is really hard, which amazes me, but that's what they do.
Okay, so one of the most important things I think you need to consider is a safe skimmer, because when they're basking, they can evade predators, but if they get sucked up into a skimmer, it's not pretty. So tell us what you've done to your skimmer to make it safe for the turtles.
Yeah, you're right. I learned the hard way. Unfortunately, I had one of my turtles go into my skimmer, and actually the pump held him down there and killed him. So it was a pretty big bummer. So I actually made a grate that I put in front of the door to stop them from being able to go into the skimmer. That's a very important thing to do because they will get sucked up. Yeah, look, they're always constantly by the skimmer. There's one swimming away right now. I found that when I feed them, the food tends to flow into the skimmer, and they've gotten really smart, and they sit right, hang out right here, wait for the food to come to them so that they don't have to go out and search for it themselves. So what I did to stop them from going in there is I just made a grate like this. Having two pumps in there, the suction is good enough, it just holds it against there. It's very important to watch for the debris of this though, because it will stop the water from going into the skimmer and can cause your pumps to run dry. So that is something to consider when you do something like this to block the water flow. You want to make sure that you don't restrict it.
So Mike, I know you went through all this elaborate setup of sandy beaches, and it looks really awesome. We did that to stimulate breeding, right? Have you had any success with breeding? Have you had any babies?
Actually, Eric, I have. Last fall when I was putting the second part of my waterfall on, I came across these two little guys right here walking along the walkway in the water. And it was the end of the season, so they must have been the last clutch of eggs that could hatch for the year, but actually I've had three altogether.
So Mike, thanks for having us over today. We learned a lot of cool stuff. Your funny stories were real cool. And you know, if I was a turtle, I guarantee I'd want to live in this backyard because it's an amazing place here. I want to say thanks, and we're going to cut out. Have a great day.
Thank you, Eric.
Let's recap those five important things you need to consider when having a pond designed for turtles. You need to have the tight perimeter. You need to have turtle tunnels so they can go deep in the pond and hide from predators and hibernate. You need to have a basking area where they can get out. The basking area is best when it's close to the pond so they can slide right back in if they get nervous or scared. They need a place where they can go and lay some eggs. Now Mike went through the elaborate beachfront property. They've tended to go other places in the yard, but you need to allow them to be able to get out and dig and lay their eggs so the females don't get egg bound. And the last and most important thing to consider is a safe skimmer. You saw how Mike put that grate in front of the skimmer so the turtles didn't get sucked up in there, and the story about how they just hang out in front of the skimmer and wait for the food to come to them because they're lazy. Those are the five most critical things I think you need to know about turtle pond construction. I hope it was informative, and have a great day.